Brothers and sisters this evening, are we ready to celebrate 30 years of godly work, or more like it, a magical evening? Are we ready to have a good time this evening? The last time we saw your faces 2 years ago, the world was different, but now we are back. We are back to celebrate 30 years. So everyone, please make some crazy noise for Double H Ranch now.
Good dancing. Well, welcome. It is so good to see all of your faces. How are you all doing today?
Good.
Good.
I see some thumbs up.
Great.
Doing great. Awesome. So good. That's awesome to hear. Well, before we go any further. Before we go too much further, let's take a second to introduce ourselves. So we're just going to say your name and where you're calling from today, okay? So I'll start. So my name is Alex. Some of you might know me as Griff. And I am calling from Glens Falls, New York today. I'm the assistant camp director at Double H, and I'm so excited to be on this call with all of you. I'm going to pass it to Zippy.
Hi, I'm Zippy, and I'm calling from Bensalem in Pennsylvania.
Awesome. Thanks, Zippy. Let's pass it to Freya.
My name is Freya, and I'm from Concord, Massachusetts.
Great. Thanks, Freya. Awesome.
I didn't say it.
That was great. How about Chloe?
My name's Chloe, and I'm in New York.
Awesome. And who are you with, Chloe? Who is that?
I'm Maddie, and I'm also calling from upstate New York.
Awesome. Hi, Chloe and Maddie. And then I'm also going to pass it to Avery.
Hi, I'm Avery, and I'm calling from upstate New York. And
who's with you?
And this is Arthur, and he's also
amazing. Oh, upstate New York. It's the place to be. You know, I really wish we could all be together in upstate New York in person right now. Wouldn't that be really great?
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Yeah. So, you know what? Why not? Why can't you know, you guys, let's go. Let's be together. Come on. Let's do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bye.
Strangers to love, you know the rules, and so do I. A full commitment's what I'm thinking of. You wouldn't get this from any other guy. I just wanna tell you how I'm feeling. Gotta make you understand. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you, never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. We've known each other for so long. Your heart's been aching, but you're too shy to say it. Inside, we both know what's been going on. We know the game and we're gonna play it. And if you ask me how I'm feeling, Don't tell me you're too blind to see. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and hurt you. Never gonna give you up, never gonna let you down, never gonna run around and desert you. Never gonna make you cry, never gonna say goodbye, never gonna tell a lie and hurt you.
Give a big round of applause.
Put your hands. Thank you. Put your hands together for tonight's performers. Campers from the Double H Ranch. And for music, we have Garland Nelson and Soul Sessions. Paul Newman, actor and philanthropist, and Charlie Wood, businessman and philanthropist, co-funded the Double H Ranch, a serious fun camp. Over the past 30 years, they've seen over 80,000 kids with serious and chronic illnesses. But they couldn't do it alone. They knew they needed a CEO with heart and drive. So they picked Max Urenda as their enduring CEO. Over Max's 30 years as CEO, he's seen over 80,000 children with serious and chronic illnesses have some fun, and as Paul Newman liked to say, raise a little hell. Please join me in welcoming Max Urenda onto the magical evening stage.
That was a very thoughtful introduction, Noah. Thank you. And I love the fake mustache. I bet you half the group tonight who I had a chance to say hello to were just so thrilled to be back at the Albany Cap Center to celebrate a very special and a very critical mission in our community, the Double H Ranch. So thank you all for being here this evening. I'd like to start out by thanking our co-chairs, Dr. Dennis and Karen McKenna. Dr. Paul Vogt and Maureen O'Brien. Certainly want to thank all our wonderful sponsors, all of you being here this evening. Our community is a very, very special one. I want to thank Garland and Soul Session for being here this evening as well, too. We have several board members with us tonight. If you could please stand and be recognized, I would appreciate that. All our board members. I certainly want to thank my very talented and dedicated year-round team. Special thank you to Jackie, Eileen, and Julia for all their extra efforts tonight to organize this beautiful performance by these beautiful children. I want to have a great shout out for our medical community, certainly the amazing partnership that we share with the Children's Hospital at Albany Medical Center that affords us the opportunity to stay in business and truly provide this wonderful experience for our kids. And most importantly, I want to recognize and thank all of our special campers and their parents who are with us this evening. Uh, 30 years ago, It seems like a long time ago, but it seems like yesterday. I'll never forget when Paul Newman first visited Double H, his first words to me were, "Max, if this community doesn't embrace you and support you from the start, you're gonna fail." So that got my attention immediately, kind of stuck in my head. And as he would come up every year to see the kids, the counselors, get to meet our board, attended some events, really got to meet the people in this community, he would say to me, "This community is different. The people in it are very special. They're genuine, and they truly care about this mission." So I think his experience in this community, Capital District up to Lake George, really reminded him that there are wonderful, wonderful people in this society. So please give yourself an applause, because it's so true. So 30 years, I'm gonna not really concentrate on what we've accomplished over 30 years. We've certainly created a reputation of excellence. What I'd like to focus on is the key, I think, takeaways or outcomes that our campers have experienced and gained through their time at Double H. A greater willingness to try new things. Enhanced self-esteem and self-identity. Resilience. They've taught us so much about resilience over the years. I think a greater sense of empathy and compassion for others, recognizing that there's kids with even greater needs. They're always there. That camper support is almost the most beautiful thing you could ever witness. Building friendship skills. I want to share a quick story. I had an opportunity last year to do a presentation at an association. I knew parents were members. They had a qualifying camper for the very first year last year. So I thought, wow, how cool would it be to have a camper present with me to the association? So I asked mom and dad, would Nolan be willing to present with me? Absolutely. So I get there. I'm waiting for him to arrive. Folks are coming into the lodge. I see in the back entry this young man wearing a pink, and it was pink, green, and yellow checkerboard jacket with a matching hat, comes over, sits right next to me. He's intensely reading. I said, "Nolan," I said, "are you a good reader?" He looks up at me. "I'm pretty much good at everything." So I'm like, okay, I think we've got this tonight. I asked him if he'd be willing to open up the presentation, which he gladly did. And these were his words. "My name is Nolan. I'm 9 years old, I have lymphoma, and I've never had a friend. Until I went to the Double H, and now I've got lots of friends." Talk about a powerful moment. These kids are our teachers, and they're just a privilege to be around at any opportunity. I'm grateful for our founders, Mr. Charlie Wood and Mr. Paul Newman, for having the courage, the generosity, the vision, and the passion for creating a very magical place that we call Double H. Right, Chloe? You got the fake mustache, too. I didn't. I think we recognized a long time ago that we're a part of something that's truly bigger than who we are. We've created an environment at Double H where we're all learning and growing together. I feel that we've created the most beloved extended family that you could ever hope for, and providing that sense of community and that sense of belonging, which is so important for all of us. And despite adversity, we have a lot of fun along the way. And on that note of fun, it is now my absolute privilege to introduce the stars of this evening, which are our campers representing 80,000 kids who have participated since 1993. And I would ask all of you to please stand at this point. I'm going to go around, and I would ask each one of you to just say your first name and something that you truly love about the... I did not give good directions. I didn't realize we had as many campers in the audience. But thank you. Sorry. So, Simon says. So again, if you would state your first name and something you love about the Double H.
My name is Zippy, and something I love about Double H is all the counselors and making new friends.
My name is Chloe, and I love about Double H Ranch because the pool is heated.
My name is Maddie, and my favorite thing about Double H is the sense of community there.
My name is Brandon, and my favorite thing about camp is the energy.
My name is Nolan. My favorite thing about camp is the community and the counselors and everyone you meet there. Thank you.
My name is Freya, and my favorite thing about Double H is the also the community.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm Noah. My favorite thing about Double H is the counselors. It would not be possible without them. Thank you, everybody who's helped and has helped in the past. Thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you, Noah.
My name is Corinne, and my favorite thing about Double H is making new friends every summer.
My name is Parker, and my favorite thing about Double H is that it even exists for kids like us that have no worry in the world and don't need to worry about all our medical stuff. And it's just a place where we can have fun.
I'm Avery, and my favorite thing about camp is probably the counselors and the community and making new friends. And also, kind of like Parker, just that we can just have fun and not worry about anything.
So you guys can have a seat. It is my privilege to introduce a young man, an accomplished musician. He has composed an original song that he wants to share with us this evening. Please, a warm welcome, Brandon.
Stand behind me, and I can be your shield. I block every bully for you. I swear I'll never yield. You can stand behind me. You can stand behind me. Oh, 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 oh.
I know it's been a while since we've seen each other smile. But I think it'd be great if me and you could take some time to figure it out. And if your world came crumbling down, just know I'd be right there. I never want to make you frown, so just know that I care. You can stand behind me, and I can be your shield. I block every bully for you. I swear I'll never yield. You can stand behind me. You can stand behind me. Oh, 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 oh.
Locked in a dead embrace, I see it in your face. A cold, forgotten frown, but life always comes around in the end. If your world came crumbling down, just know I'd be right there. I never want to make you frown, so just know that I care. You can stand behind me, And I can be your shield. I block every bullet for you. I swear I'll never yield. You can stand behind me. And I block every bullet for you. I swear I'll never yield. Oh, oh. I swear I'll never yield, oh, oh, oh. Yeah, I can be your shield. Well,
Brandon, that was amazing. I love how the title is called Shield, because at Double H Camp is really a shield and really protects us. Thank you for sharing your original song and incredible talent.
For the next part of the show, we would like to welcome someone special to the stage. We might find him in the best this way. Parker to Dr. Dennis, Parker to Dr. Dennis.
This is Dr. Dennis, go.
What's your 20?
I'm sitting over here, sitting next to Max.
Dr. Dennis, please make your way to the stage stacked.
10-4, I'll be right there.
Floors! Doors! Let's go! This is our home, we've got every generation. Full of music, a rhythm of its own design. This is my family, a perfect constellation. So many stars and everybody gets to shine. Whoa, let's be clear, Abuela runs this show. Whoa, she led us here so many years ago. Whoa, and every year our family blessings grow. There's just a lot you simply got to know. So, welcome to the family, Madrigal.
Yeah.
The home of the family, Madrigal. We're where all the people are fantastical and magical. I'm part of the family, Madrigal.
Oh, my
God, it's them!
What are the gifts?
I can't remember all the gifts.
All right, relax.
It is physically impossible to relax everything. What are yours?
All right. All right. The last thing you all want to see is to have me dance, so I'm glad that part of it is over. It's good to see you all, and welcome to the fourth magical evening. We were talking about this earlier, and we were saying that it was 2 years ago when we did this, and it seems like a lot changed in the last 2 years. But for those of you who are here for the fourth time, we welcome you back. This is fantastic. And if you're here for the first time, we welcome you for the first time. And we're just so pleased to be here together in person celebrating the greatness that is Double H. And let me extend my sincere thanks to Maureen and Paul. I think I say this every year, but we will be happy to ride your coattails every year as we do. I think, you know, you're responsible for about 3/4 of the people here. So thank you so much for partnering with you. And of course, to my lovely wife, Karen. Thank you, Karen, for everything as well. So thank you. The theme tonight is, what does camp mean to you? And I think if you talk to people who spend time at camp, they'll tell you that camp means different things to different people, and it means different things to people at different times. And there'll be a video tonight that I think that will explore that more deeply. For me, camp is about a lot of things. But one of the things that is very important to me, it's about perspective. So I wear this courage bracelet, and I've had it on my wrist for the last 7 years since I've been at camp, and I wear it all the time. I've never taken it off. And for me, it's a visual reminder of what is possible at camp and the courage that the campers can show us. And at times when I have needed a personal boost when I felt like it's been difficult, and who amongst us in the last couple years hasn't needed that? This bracelet is a reminder to me of camp and what's possible. And so some of us wear the courage bracelets, in some cases people carry it in their heart, but we all carry it in one or two particular ways. The other thing which camp is magic, and we call this the magical evening. And it occurred to me that this is the fourth year, and we've never done a magic trick. So who here wants to see a magic trick? All right? All right, so I think I'm going to have Avery be my partner. So would you mind holding this for 1 second for me? Okay. First of all, is there a deck of cards available? Back, shuffle those cards for us, please. Shuffle. So they're shuffled up. Are they well shuffled?
Very well shuffled.
They're well shuffled. All right, so we're going to put these in this box right here. And Avery, I'm going to ask you to hold this deck. Don't let anybody touch it. Hold it right out in front of you. All right, we're going to watch. Make sure, Avery, nobody comes by, takes that deck. Now, in the meantime, Parker and I are going to do a couple jokes together. Are you ready, Parker? Why don't you grab yourself a stool there? I'll grab the microphone. Come on closer to me, Parker. All right, so has anyone taken the deck from you yet? Are you sure? All right, keep a close eye. Make sure no one does it, because it has to be in her hands the whole time. Parker, good to see you. Parker, do you know any good doctor jokes?
Well, you being a doctor in charge of Albany Med, I think that's a joke to me.
Sometimes I can't believe it myself, Parker. Okay. Doctor, I have a strawberry stuck in my ear.
Not to worry, I have a cream for that.
All right. Why did the can you please, thank you. This can't drop. This is a very important part. No one can touch that. Why did the mattress go to the doctor?
It had spring fever.
Oh, okay. This side needs to laugh a little bit more over here. Maybe we should, okay. Doctor, I think I'm a goat.
How long have you felt this way?
Since I was a kid. We're only halfway done. Hang in there. Doctor, every time I stand up too quickly, I see Donald Duck and Mickey Mouse.
Fascinating. How long have you had these Disney spells?
That's a good one. Disney spells. All right. Doctor, I keep seeing insects spinning around me.
Oh, yes. Haven't you heard there's a bug going around?
And I think this is our best, so get ready. Doctor, I've got broccoli stuck in my ear.
Well, it looks like you aren't eating properly.
All right. Give it up for Parker. Now, Avery, has anybody touched that deck of cards? Are you sure?
Yes.
Nobody has touched it?
Nobody.
Can you please hand it back to me? Okay. All right, so we're going to take the deck of cards out of here. All right, now, Avery, you tell me when to stop. You
okay.
Decide when to stop, okay? I'm going to look the other way. You tell me when to stop.
Stop.
Are you sure?
Yes.
You want to go any further or not?
I'm sure.
You're sure. All right, so we're going to put this card right here. I'm going to put this card right here. I'd like you to come over here and put your hands right on top of it. Make sure no one touches it. All right, now, who here knows a magical, do you know any magical words? Does anybody know any?
Yeah.
What is it?
Abracadabra.
That's it. Okay, abracadabra. Hold that. Take your hands off here a second. Okay, now this is where you cut the deck, right? Okay. Take the first card off the top. Don't let us look at it. Okay, now Parker and I, we're mentalists. What are you thinking? 7 o'clock. Parker has, he knows what it is. Go ahead, Parker.
Three of aces.
The three, well, you have to pick a suit. Hearts, diamonds, clubs.
Three of hearts.
Is it the three of hearts? We made a small mistake. We're sorry. Go ahead, reveal the card, Parker.
Six of spades.
All right, hold on a second here. Hold this, please.
Okay.
All right, so I took out an insurance policy before we did this. And this is the magician's insurance policy. And what this says is that any person must not be heckled by, must not heckle the magician. So that might have affected things. It says this policy gives the magician the right to use real magic. And this policy guarantees the magician will not fail. So I don't know why it is that it didn't work. What card is it, Avery?
King.
The King of Hearts. Unbelievable. Been practicing that one for 47 years. And my brothers can agree to that. Now, to close out our magic trick, all of you have underneath your plate a playing card, and there's a special gift here that we have for whoever matches up with the King of Hearts. So who has the King of Hearts under their plate? It's Dr. Ray Walsh. Now, just to show that this is totally magic, in this bag is a sweatshirt. Now, we all know Dr. Ray loves to wear his sweatshirts at camp. And on this sweatshirt, it has three places, which not only is very important to Dr. Ray, but also finds Dr. Ray very important. Double H, Albany Med, and Siena College. And so congratulations, Ray, on winning the magic trick. We'll bring this down to you. Can you bring this down to me? When you talk about what camp means to you, sometimes it's important to remember those people who are important to camp, and Dr. Ray is absolutely one of them. Okay, now it is my distinct pleasure to introduce to the stage my very good friend and a fabulous singer. Wait, she's here right in front of me. It's Maddie. Maddie's going to sing. Come on over, Maddie.
Hey everyone. I hope y'all enjoy.
Hope when you take that jump, don't fear the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, they're screaming your name. Hope when everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Suffer, but take the pain. But until the moment comes, I'll say, I did it all. I did it all. I owned every second that this world could give. Saw so many places, the things that I did, every broken bone, I swear I live. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Oh.
of America. Wait, no. Stop. Maddie, that was awesome. It felt like we were back at camp for a talent show.
Freya and I know firsthand the impact Double H has on campers. We both have countless stories about new friendships, our favorite counselors, and trying new activities for the first time. A personal favorite of mine is using Newman-owned cartons of juice as archery targets. Camp affects everyone who gets to be a part of it, like many of the volunteers, donors, and staff who are in this room tonight. Thank you to Albany Medical Center for capturing just a few of our important stories. We hope you enjoy a glimpse into the power of camp.
So 10, 20, 30 years down the road, I'd want you to know exactly what you were like when you were on chemotherapy. It is one of my proudest moments as a parent. You figured it out, you hustled, you were nice to people even though you didn't feel good. It's one of my proudest things.
From the moment that we met, I knew you were gonna be a really special little girl. And the day that you were diagnosed with cancer was probably the hardest day of my entire life. But I knew from that day that you were going to be a huge fighter and that you were going to be able to overcome all of the obstacles put in your way. You're only 11 months old, but you are a feisty little one.
Chris, you mentioned that when you were just starting to go to camp, you were surrounded by campers who may have had similar experiences that you had, having had cancer, but different than the kids that you went to school with back home.
Right.
Can you talk a little bit more about that?
Sure. So I think, you know, when I was a kid, I was going through treatment. I was bald. I was the only bald kid in school. I physically stood out from all of my peers at school. And then, you know, I would have long stints in the hospital. I'd be missing weeks of school at a time. And so, you know, emotionally, I would stand out from my peers at school. Come to camp, everybody looks a little bit different at camp, and that's the normal. Everybody is at different social and emotional developmental stages, and that's the normal. And yet we still have an absolute blast the entire week.
I didn't have a lot of friends when I was younger. So the way, you know, you meet with the counselors, you meet with these campers, and you make these friends, which gives you the encouragement and the strength to do other things. I don't think I'd be where I am with Double H, because Double H, when I was really young, was this light in the darkness for me and my family that just made me look forward to through all the chemo, all the blood transfusions and all that.
One time this girl said the only reason I was popular was because I had cancer, and that really hurt me. But Double H is nothing like that. And they're like, you are strong because you had cancer and you can do anything, because if you can beat cancer, you can do anything.
You know, camp is a very unique place in terms of, you know, you'll hear people say you can be yourself there. And I think that was really important to me as a kid, where, you know, I was the only kid that I knew who had cancer in my school. And, you know, I come to camp and I was surrounded by people who might not have had cancer, but, you know, they had that experience of being the only one in their situation. So that was really powerful for me.
When you come to the hospital, they help you get better. They give you the medicine you need to be well. and to control whatever disease it is that you have. We had everything we needed medically. We didn't have everything that we needed when you were young on how to live. And we really desperately needed that. I was overwhelmed with everything I had to manage medically. And when we came in here one day to Albany Med and Dr. Porter said to us, you know, Gabe's eligible for Double H. He should go to Double H. I remember thinking to myself, there's no way you can get dropped off at camp. There's just no way. And then she explained to me the medical component of camp. And that was your respite. It was your time where you learned confidence. It was your time where you found your sense of humor. It was your time where you were around other kids like you.
What are some of the skills you learned as a counselor that make you better prepared to be a physician?
Good question. Being a counselor at camp is a lot of just controlling organized chaos, which I feel like has benefited me quite well in the emergency department, where, you know, you have a lot of things going on at the same time, and as you can keep a pulse on a lot of the situation, but allow some stuff to play out as it goes.
Me, Daddy, Sissy, Grandma, Papa, all of your aunts and uncles and cousins, they were all there for you every day. Loving you, loving to hear the progress that you were doing. But I also want you to know that it wasn't just your family that was there. You had an entire community of people around you who were rooting for you.
When people look at death, there's two things that happen. You can either laugh it off or you can get really scared. I chose to laugh it off. That, you know, through MRIs and hospitals and doctors, you kind of have to look at the funny things instead of the sad things.
Give life all you got, because you don't know what's gonna happen, so you just wanna enjoy life in the moment while it's all good and fine. So you just kind of wanna enjoy every second that you have.
That's the idea that Albany Med Double H bring. That don't feel sorry for yourself because you have this thing. Work it.
When you were a counselor, did you see young campers who reminded you of yourself at that age? And did you connect with them in a different way? And perhaps give them some opportunities for insights that you had learned?
I tried to facilitate that between the campers. Between each other.
Not between you and them.
Correct, yeah. So, you know, I shared my experience a couple of times with campers, but it was more so I tried to, one, let them be as crazy as they wanted to be, because that's what I did when I was a camper, and then also, you know, foster those relationships with their peers, because I think that was one of the more important things that I gained from camp.
I mean, I think that's what we call the magic of camp, right?
Yes.
Just that ability to take all those issues, put them aside, and then let them have some common experience together.
We were like, oh my gosh, this is like the most magical place on earth, and it's like more magical than Disneyland. Like, I'd rather go here than Disneyland.
I just think it taught you a lot, and I'm enormously grateful to the people that we met through Double H and the fun that you had there. You had to have fun. And going to a hospital every day was not fun.
I think Double H gives us as a family a great place to be and to connect with people that just absolutely adore all of the campers and the campers' families.
But I think the biggest thing that we're all celebrating is that if you were to send my mom 10 years ago, I would be graduating high school, number 9 in my class, and going to college. I don't think she would have believed you. That the odds were stacked against me, and I pulled through, and that's because of Double H and Albany Med.
I love you, Gabe.
Love you too, Mama.
One thing I always want you to remember, no matter where you go in life, because I know you're going to do big things in it, I want you to remember you have the courage, you have the strength, you have the ambition, you have the intelligence to do whatever your heart desires.
Sit.
And I love you so much for everything you have taught me over the past 10 years. You've taught me how to be a better person, to be a better mother, to be a better family member, to be a better therapist, to be just a better human in life. And I thank you for teaching me that. I love you so much.
I love you.
I'm not crying, you guys are crying. So first of all, I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Gabe, but first let's give a big round of applause to our campers. Now, my favorite thing at Double H over the past 10 years has been Great Escape, but also the surrounding support that 10 years ago I was a camper, and now this year I'm gonna be a CIT. So, it really is this happy little cult. They wrap you in there. So first, I want to talk about why we're all here tonight. It's Double H. It's the greatest place on earth. I would like you all to open your hearts and your wallets to this place. But next, I have to get all these kids cheering, because my dad loves kids. Loud kids. So now, everyone give it up for my dad, Dr. Paul F. Vogt.
Good evening. Please eat if you have not. My name is Paul Vogt. I am the father of a camper. I am the husband of a former board member and the only man crazy enough to take this stage after that video and these kids' performances. Our job here tonight is simple and fast. I'm going to read live auction items. You're going to bid lots of money. I'm going to point at you. You're going to win. Then someone's gonna come over and take your credit card. Any questions? By the way, who had the joke about him being in charge of Albany Med? 2 years ago, I said, what is this COVID thing? He said, don't worry about it. A guy ate a bat, we'll be fine. He runs Albany Med. One last rule follower, I do not do the items in order on the sheet. So whatever order you think you might be bidding on, just please keep up, because we're going to do these in a completely different order than on the sheet. Our first item is the ultimate quilt. It's over there in the corner. Donated by Friends of Double H. It's handcrafted from t-shirts that they found for the past 30 years of Double H camp. History and beauty all tied into one quilt. We're going to start the bidding at $300. $300. Hang on 1 second. Timeout. Sorry. Coach Dumel, this is a 30. This is a full. I know you had problems with that this year. There's a pretty Irish girl sitting there who tries to bid. That's my wife. As a compliance issue, she's not allowed to bid. I save a fortune at these things being the auctioneer. Gabriel, you don't have any money. The ultimate quote, 300. I need three. Three, I need three. Give me three. Someone give me three. 300 right there. I need four. Four, give me four. I got four. Four, I need five. Five, give me five. Someone give me five. Give me five. I got five right there. Five, I need six. We're going fast. Five, I need six. Somebody give me six. Somebody give me six. I got five here. Nobody give me six. I got six. I got six here. Someone give me seven. 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 Eight. 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 Look at me. Don't look at her. She doesn't want you to win this. Eight. You want eight. Nine. Nine. Do I get nine? Nine right there. Thousand. Thousand. 1,200. 1,200. 12. I get 12. We're going twos now. 14. 1,500. 1,500. 1,500. Sir, I'm over here. 1,500. 16. 16, 1600, 17. She doesn't want you to win it. Why are you looking at her? $2,000, $2,000 for the quilt, $2,000. $2,000, you good? You good? You good? Congratulations, $2,000, me and you. Nice job, $2,000. Thank you so very much. We're moving now. Matt, are you going to help me with this one? This is you. Okay. This next one is Jimmy Makes Pizza. This amazing package includes fire hand-tossed pizza, come to your location, to your house, to a park. Cheese, pepperoni, specialty pizzas for 25 to 50 people. Includes lemonade plates, the napkins, all donated by Team Gallagher. Maddie Gallagher is part of the team. She'll come and sing for you as well. What is going on? Gabe, control the room, please. What a great idea. If you got a graduation, a birthday party, first communion, anything like that coming up, please bid. We're going to start the bidding at $1,000. $1,000. Where are my spotters? $1,000. We got $1,000 right here. $1,000. I need $1,200. $1,200's next. $1,200. $1,200 anywhere. Anywhere. I got $1,000. I need $12. $1,000. I need $12. I got $1,200. $1,500. $1,500. $2,000. $2,000. I got $2,000. $2,500. $2,500. $2,500. Do I have three over here? Three anywhere. $2,500 here. $2,500 going anywhere else. People yell. Three. $3,000. I got $3,000. Where else was I? $3,500. I got $3,000. $3,500. $3,500. Sir, you're not paying attention. $3,500. $3,500. I got three. $3,500. $3,500. $3,000. $3,000. I got $3,500. $3,500. Anyone else? Anyone else? Where? What, back here? We got $3,500 back there. How much?
Four.
$4,000. I got $4,000 there. $4,000. $4,000. $4,500. You can't hide. You're right there. I can see you. You can't hide. This is awesome. You're going to go next. $4,000 once. Sold. Thank you very much. $4,000 in the corner. Any Notre Dame fans here? Who's here? We have six tickets to the Notre Dame-UNLV game on October 22nd. It includes parking passes, tickets on the 50-yard line, seven rows from the field, donated by Mr. Frank Anise. We're going to start the bidding at $2,000. $2,000. $2,000 right here. $2,000. $2,500. $2,500 anywhere. I got $2,000. $2,500. $2,500. Awesome, I got 2,000, 2,500, three. Do I have three? I have 3,000. 3,500, four. 4,000 here, 45? 4,500, 4,500 there, 5,000 here. Anyone else willing to get middle of this? Done, you're done, I got 5,000 here. Anyone go 5,500, 5,500. Come on, he's a Clemson fan. I can't have him win these tickets. He's gonna try to trade him for somebody for the Clemson game later in the year. I know what he's doing, I don't trust him. 5,000 going once. Anyone? 5,500. Anyone? Anyone? Where? 5,500? 5,500. Do I have six? Come on. Okay. Clemson fans out. I got 5,500. Anyone else? Anyone do six? 5,500. 6,000. 6,000 here. 6,000. 6,000. I got 6,000 once. 6,000 twice. Sold. $6,000. Thank you very much, Mr. Trimble. How are we doing on time? We moving? We're doing good? Everybody's happy? Outstanding. All right, we're doing a special item, not on the list. Got a newsflash of a special item. On your tables, there is a golf outing sheet. Several different golf outings this year, sponsored by Double H Ranch. We're going to give away a foursome to the June 9th event at the Sagamore Resort. We're going to start that bidding at $700. $700 for a foursome, breakfast, lunch, the foursome. Golf balls right there, $700. Maddie J, you playing? $800 there, I got $800, $800. Give me $900, I got $899. $800, I need $900. I got $900 right here. $900, I need $1,000, I got $1,000. $1,000 there, I got $1,000, I need $1,200. I got $1,000, I need $12. Maddie, is your hand up? $1,200, $1,200, no? Maddie nodded. I got $1,200 here, I need $1,300 over here. No, Maddie J's in for 12. I like Maddie J. I got 1,200, I need 13. 1,300 right there. 1,300, 14, 2,000 right here. I got 2,000 right there. Anyone else want to match 2,000? Anyone want to match 2,000? I got one here at 2,000. 2,000? No, you're out? No? Okay, Maddie, you don't move your head at all. That's the key. You got to stay perfectly still. Somebody's gonna cheat the kid. $2,000 going once. What? How much? $2,000. I'm gonna get in trouble. I'm giving away two. One for $2,000 there. One for $2,000. Who was the other $2,000? Over here. One for $2,000. One for $2,000. We're done. Giving away two of them. The next item, Sunday at the Sauce Queens. Is she here? Could she stand up and be recognized? Is she here? I don't know if she's here or not. Oh, there she is right there. Thank you very much. Being donated by Adine Viscusi. This is on a mutual agreeable date. Group of 10 can come to her home, and she will teach you how to make an authentic Sunday Italian dinner. Her company is also the owner of Casa Visca Sauces. There was a silent auction item as well. Thank you so much for your generosity. And you can buy her pasta sauces at any local Price Chopper or Market 32. Did I get that right, sir? Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Gold. Thank you. I'm doing my best for you, sir. Doing my best. Ooh, it does not have to be a Sunday. It could be for any special event, a rehearsal dinner, any time that you would like to come and do it. We're going to start the bidding at $1,000. $1,000. You can't bid. $1,000. $1,000. I got $1,000 here. I got 12. I got $1,000. I need 12. I got 1,200. 1,200. I need 14. 12. I need 14. I got 1,200. I need 14. 1,200. I need 14. Come on, somebody. 1,400. I got 1,200. I need 14. I need 14 from somebody. I got 1,400 back here. Thank you very much. 14. I need 16. 14. I need 16. I got 14. I need 16. 14. Nobody else. Nobody else. 14. 14. Once. Twice sold, $1,400. Thank you very much. We're winding down, we're winding down. The next one, from our great friends and our great friends of Double H Ranch, Mazone Hospitality, they are gonna offer, this one's a little confusing. It's basically a custom party at your house. They're gonna throw in, some friends of Double H are throwing in some wine, some centerpieces, some beer. There's gonna include dessert. It's basically $1,000 off of whatever you want to design with Mazone Hospitality. So again, you have a graduation party coming up, you have a first communion party, a rehearsal dinner at your house. Mazone Catering comes, they'll clean everything up, they'll do everything for you. It's a fantastic package. We're going to start the bidding for this at $800. $800, I got to get $800 for this. $800 right here, outstanding. $900 right there. I got $900, I need $1,000. $900, I need $1,000. $900, I need $1,000. $1,000, outstanding. $1,000. Where? Right there, 1,200. I got 1,200 right there. 12, I need 13. 12, I need 13. 13, anybody over here? 13, anyone over here? I got 1,200. 1,200, 1,300 right there. Outstanding. Thank you very much. 13, I need 14. Come on. 1,400 right there. 14, I need 15. 14, I need 15. 14, I need 15. Mary Beth, pay attention. 14, I need 15. 14, I need 15. There you go. Thank you very much. 14, I need 15. You got to pay attention, Nana. I'm losing you. 14, I need 15. I need 1,500. 15 anywhere, 1,500 right there, 15, 1,600, 1,600, 1,600, 1,600, 16, I need 17, 16, I need 17, 16, I need 17, wait, I got 1,700, 17, I need 18, 1,700, I need 1,800, I got 1,700, 1,700 once, twice, what do we got here, 1,800, 1,800, I got 1,800, late to the party, 1,800, I need two. Two? 2,000, 2,000 here. I got 2,000 here. 22, 24? What do you want to give me? 24?
You guys need a few minutes?
2,200? I got 22, 24. 22, I need 24. 2,400 there. 24, 25. 25? 2,500 there, 25, 26, then, no, you out, 25, out. 2,500 once, twice, sold, $2,500, thank you very much. Okay, now we have a big one. Alderbrook Lodge in Bolton with a private lake. Three-night weekend stay, 16 people, 8 bedrooms. Owners will work with you on the dates. They'll do their best. It's on the Scroon River, 20 minutes from the Sagamore Resort. That's for me because camping for me is the mini bar's not in the room. I'm not staying in a resort. So that You can celebrate a birthday, a holiday, something special with a group of 16 people, a corporate retreat. Somebody used it for a couple of years ago. So we're going to start the bidding on this great prize donated by Attlebrook Lodge, Jess Wilcox, and Jeff Gardner at $2,500. $2,500 right there. $2,500, I need three. $25, I need three. $3,000 back there. $3,000, three, I need 35. I got three, I need 35. Three, I need 35. Where do I got 35? I got 35 right there. 35, I need four. 35, I need four. 4,000 right there. 45, 45 right there. I got 45, I need five. Scream it out, 45, I need five. Anyone else, 5,000 right there, 5,000. 5,000, I need 55. 5,000, 55 right there, I need six. 6,000, I need 65. I got 65 right there, I need seven. Don't look surprised, seven right there. You know what's coming next, 75. 7,500 right there, 75. 75, I need eight. Eight, get angry. That's new Albany money trying to steal this from you. That's old Albany money doesn't back down. $8,500. New Albany, oh, come on, old Albany. I need 9,000. I got 85, I need nine. I got 85, I need nine. New money's gonna win. 9,000, there you go. Come on. Done. 9,000, I need 95. 9,000, 9,000 going once, twice, sold. $9,000. Thank you very much. Always challenge old money. They always give it up. Old money always gives it up. Okay, so we have one last thing we're going to do tonight that I have to do, and that's to talk about some camper sponsorships. So it costs $2,500 for a camper to go to Double H for a week, and absolutely not a dime of that comes from the families of the kids that go there. It comes from events like this and the generosity of this crowd. So we have two matching events going on tonight. So on your tables, you can see, what are they called, QR codes? Sorry, it's starting to pass me by. There's QR codes on the table. There's also pieces of paper where you can fill out donations. And here's what we need to get to. If we hit $10,000 from what we're gonna do right now, we get a $10,000 match. That match is coming from Matt and Lois Emmons. Thank them. If we hit $23,000, there's another match coming from Cheryl and Barry Schwartz in camper sponsorship. So we gotta hit $23,000 or else Maureen gets mad at me. So here's how I want you to think about this, right? If you came here tonight on a corporate invitation, you came here with friends, what would you have paid for this kind of entertainment, save the auctioneer, right? Would you have paid $200 a couple? $250 a couple. If I get 100 families to commit to $250 right now, we blow the number out of the water. If you can do more, please do so. But if you can commit to $250 a couple, stand up and show us you're willing to do that tonight. Stand up and say that tonight was worth $250 for you to be in the room. And let somebody make sure we got 100 people standing up. We'll blow this match out of the water. Thank you. Thank you very much. So two last things as I clean up. One, Dennis says all the time that I'm on his coattail. To chair something with the McKennas is always an honor. And I just want to give one last comment. We're supposed to say what we like about Double H, and what I like is that Gabe used to go away. Thank you, everybody. Who's next? Nolan, are you back up? Who's back up? Ladies and gentlemen, Maddie Gallagher.
Oh, check. All right. I hope you guys have had an amazing evening, and I would love for you all to... Oh, hold on 1 second. We have an announcement.
Wow, the generosity in this room tonight is inspiring. Thank you to everyone here for making camp possible. A special thanks to all of our generous donors and sponsors this evening, including Dr. Paul Vaught and Maureen O'Brien, Dr. Dennis and Karen McKenna, Albany Medical Center, CBA, Holy Names, Garland, and our friends at Double H.
Finally, as Double H campers, we know there is one special group of people who had made so much possible, including camp. Thank you to our parents for being here tonight and supporting us always. And I would like to invite my friend Maddie for our closing song.
Thank you, Chloe. All right, I hope you guys have had an amazing evening, and it is with great honor that I would love to play you out. And sing along if you know it. I'm sure most of you will, so please do.
Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us, above us only sky. Imagine all the people living life in peace. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for, and no religion too.
Brothers and sisters, I do not know about you.
stage tonight did a marvelous job. Make some noise for them. I know we can make more noise than that. Let's show them what they're expected to do when they become adults. Our future leaders. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for your time. The party is not over. In fact, we're about to just start kicking it off right now. So why not, as we're doing God's work, continue to have fun? Is that cool with you? So, Session, let's do the thing, y'all. Come on.